ATM kan. Tak apa, itu rezeki dia. Saya tak apa.
Allah ya Ram, dia tak boleh tengok orang susah. Orang putak belit dengan dia. Derma, siapa tak boleh pukul dia.
He was also generous in his professional life. Even when he was already a big name, he willingly shared top billing with his co-stars, often reviving other people's flagging careers. It was actress Sarima who was discovered and nurtured by Ramlee 10 years earlier that still believed in his talents and asked him to direct her new film.
Sehari sebelum dia meninggal tu, saya, arwah suami saya, kita ada dekat Shah Motel. Dan memang nak tawar dia, saya dah lupa apa tajuknya cerita tu, dan memang dia setuju.
The offer from Sarima and her husband filled P. Ramlee with a new optimism. But P. Ramlee was never again to set foot on a film set. Before dawn on the 29th of May 1973, P. Ramlee had a heart attack at home. Saloma accompanied him in the ambulance to the Kuala Lumpur hospital. Their son, Sazali, waited at home with the younger children. A few hours later, Sazali received the dreaded call from Saloma. He refused to believe her at first.
Betul, mama dah suruh doktor dah tiga kali pam dah, dia punya dada dah. Doktor cakap meninggal. Habis kita pun dapat tahu, orang gaji dengan adik-adik menangis lah.
Sazali, who was 15 then, recalls his father's last words to him just before the heart attack.
Jaga mama baik-baik. Dia kata, jaga adik-adik elok. Jangan tinggal mama, apa sekalipun terjadi. Kalau kecuali mama dah tak ada lagi, kau nak pergi, pergilah. Tapi pergi dengan cara baik.
P. Ramlee, a great man and a true genius, had died far before his time. He was the original hero of the Malay film world, his brilliance and kindness an inspiration to many. The news of P. Ramlee's death at the age of 44 was met with disbelief.
Saya lemah bila dengar dia meninggal, lemah tenaganya, air mata ni bercucur. Belakang saya cakap dengan Saloma lah, kita nak turun, kita nak tengok mayat dia. Saloma tak kasih tengok. Dia bilang, P. Ramlee pesan dia tak nak tengok siapa pun dia mati. Itu kita kecil hati sikitlah dengan Saloma.
Saya dengar kat radio, P. Ramlee meninggal kan. Saya terus pergi rumah dia. Mungkin jam belum ada lagi orang ramai, saya tengok dia. Tapi mayat dia, saya tengok betul-betul dia senyum tu.
When his first son Nasir heard the news, he wasn't sure how to react. He couldn't believe it at first.
Tapi bila saya tengok mayat di atas simen itu baru saya pun. Datang doktor pun dia tolak mata, dia tolak hidung yang mana. Doktor saya marah dia orang pun. Siapa nak bedah pun, tak bagi bedah. No, leaving one piece dia.
Nasir said Saloma was in a daze throughout the funeral. She acted as if everything was normal.
Dia lawat juga. Tapi dia betul lebih ramai.
Dia cinta sejati. Sebelum dia meninggal, dia cakap dengan saya, "Ya, aku nak mati dah. Tak nak hidup lagi." "Apa kau cakap ni?" cakap. "Buat apa aku nak hidup? Daddy dah tak ada," dia kata. "Kau tolonglah bila aku dah mati nanti, kau kuburkan aku kat sebelah dia."
Saloma was quoted in the newspapers as saying after P. Ramlee's death, "Even if I were to die and somehow live again, I would never find a husband as good as P. Ramlee." When Saloma died, almost 10 years after P. Ramlee, Mariani kept her promise to her sister. She made sure they were together, side by side, in their final resting place.
Tiba-tiba dia bersuara kat saya, "Haji, kalau gua mati, gua akan hidup 1,000 tahun lagi."
The sudden death of P. Ramlee, the greatest star of the Malay entertainment world at the age of 44, came as a complete shock to Malaysians. For close friends, his death had only just begun to sink in. They started to recall how oddly he had behaved before he died.
Jadi selegan ni datang jumpa saya. Asal dia maki rumah. Dia baiknya rumah sial. Nak balik makan nasi tak ada. Nasi yang sebenarnya selama saya duduk rumah Pilandi tak pernah tak ada. Pada itu hari tak ada nasi.
Dia selalu baiknya saya bila saya datang. Hari itu saya datang nak jenguk Saloma. Dia rampas Melissa umur 6 bulan. Dia bawa pergi belakang. Dia tak nak cakap dengan saya. Malam tu dia meninggal.
Ramli's son, Nasir, believed he had a premonition of his father's death.
I dah habis kerja, I balik rumah. Dalam pukul 4 lebih, I macam orang tumbuk perut I ni, I cakap, kerana Allah tak bohong, eh? Macam orang tumbuk perut I tau. I terbangun tau. Alamak, pasal ni. Macam waktu I tidur balik. Pagi tu, polis datang ketuk pintu.
Ramli's close friends attributed his heart attack to the anxiety of a recent court summons.
Yang dia meninggal ni pun pasal dia terkejut. Dia jamin satu hamba Allah. Jadi besoknya tu ada kes lah.
Waktu dia belum meninggal, 3-4 hari saya jumpa dia lah. Dia kena pikot kan. Ada dia kena saman kan. Janggut pun ada. Dia susah hati. Piramli ni, yang saya tahu, dia takut doktor. Dia tak pernah pergi doktor. Yang satu dia takut orang saman dia.
On the day of the funeral, Ramli Jr., his long-time personal assistant, was worried.
Sebab itu, waktu dia meninggal, saya susah hati. Saya cakap Saloma, Kak, macam mana ni, Kak? Nak ke bumi, Kak? Saya takut tak ada orang. Saya takut tak ada orang. Pasal waktu itu memang tak ada kawan. Tak adalah siapa datang rumah dia tanya. Memang dia susah betul. Hari itu memang tak ada. Hari dia meninggal memang tak ada duit. Termasuk Saloma pun tak ada, tak ada duit. HM Shah. Bantu semua HM Shah. HM Shah bagi RM3,000 pada Saloma.
Ramli Jr. couldn't have been more wrong. Hundreds of people thronged the house, mosque and burial grounds to pay their last respects to P. Ramli. On the 29th of May, 1973, in the burial grounds in Kuala Lumpur, the world said goodbye to P. Ramli for the last time. Today, the memory of P. Ramli is fiercely and loyally protected by a nation that can't quite forgive itself for the way he was treated and will not tolerate any criticism of him.
Kau paper keluar hentam P. Ramli gini. Masih jawab lah, tak payah juga. Besok orang lain jawab hentam dia balik. So, dia orang hantar lah.
When it came out that neither Ramli nor any Malaysian owned the rights to his films, many were emotionally crushed. His films could not be screened locally without permission from the owners, the Shaw organization. While others continued to profit from his films, P. Ramli's family was completely left out.
Errol, Shaw, ini semua kita punya property. All ours.
Concerned organizations in the Malaysian entertainment industry helped his family gain copyrights to some of his songs. This is the only legacy of P. Ramli that belongs to them. According to Nasir, his father had planned to use the royalties from his songs to perform the Hajj to Makkah.
Did I plan? Dengan Saloma nak pergi round the world. Sampai pergi haji sekali dia bang.
But by the time the royalties came through, Ramli had passed away.
Mari kita berdendam.
To P. Ramli's legion of loyal fans, brand P. Ramli is very much alive beyond the realm of copyright. Ramli composed over 390 songs in his lifetime. His music recognized all around the world. In more recent years, younger generations of Malaysian singers have re-recorded P. Ramlee's songs with varying success.
Engkau laksana bulan, tinggi di atas kayangan. Hatiku dah kau tawan, hidupku tak karuan.
Saya sendiri pun bila sampaikan lagu Allahyarham Tan Sri P. Ramlee ini, rasanya sampai menusuk ke dalam jiwa lah kalau kita menyanyi.
To his loyal fans, however, Ramlee breathed a certain life into his songs, stirring the heart of anyone listening to them.
Sebenarnya lagu-lagu itu tak boleh dimodernkan. Sebab lagu itu dah, itulah asal dia, dia punya itulah karakter Hopi Ramlee. Katalah Mona Lisa punya painting, dia cuba nak buat tambah color. Cannot. That's a work of the people you must respect.
Disambut dengan suka. P. Ramlee had no formal education in music, yet he rose to become one of the greatest musicians in the country. He wanted music to be taught from an early stage in Malaysian schools, so the passion and love for traditional music would be inspired from young and never forgotten.
Kalau kita tidak semaikan music-music tradisional asli ini ke dalam dada anak-anak kita, anak muda kita, usaha di satu hari musik lain akan mengambil tempat. Kerana di dalam dada mereka itu kosong, tidak ada apa-apa. Semua macam kita mengajar anak kita pergi belajar agama. Walau bagaimanapun, dia pergi berapa tinggi pun, dia jarang tidak menukar agama. Kerana agama yang telah diajar oleh bapaknya telah tersimpan dalam dada dia. Itu juga musik, supaya musik lain tak boleh memperoleh jiwanya.
Cinematically, Ramlee is most fondly remembered for his portrayal of the innocent, downtrodden hero or the charming, mischievous playboy, his own wicked sense of humor often permeating his films. His last film, Laksmana Do Re Mi, was a spoof of his own losing battle for viewership. It was probably the lowest budget film he ever made, but he and his co-stars had the time of their lives doing the spoof.
Zam Zam Allakazam!
Ramlee's influence on Malay popular culture today remains unstoppable. Even in death, his magic finds its way into the hearts of successive generations of Malaysians.
Banyak yang kita boleh pelajari ya daripada karya-karya beliau, dan kenapa dia masih boleh ada entertainment value yang sangat tinggi. Segi-segi dialog dia yang tidak pernah waste. Tak pernah wasted, kita pasti dengar, ingat, segar dengan kita.
Without P. Ramlee, Malaysia would be very different, I think. He set very high standards for all of us. Can your song be as good as a P. Ramlee song? Can your movie be as good as a P. Ramlee movie?
Decades later, there is still no substitute for Malaysia's charismatic genius.
Semua dia bikin sendiri. Bikin skrip, mengarah, berlakon, cipta lagu, editing. Saya tak fikir kita dapat lagi satu P. Ramlee lah.
Memang tak ada orang teruk banding, tak ada orang boleh ganti tempat dia. Tak ada orang boleh ganti tempat dia.
Secantik bahasa untuk ku puji adinda, tiada gambar secantik lukisan untuk ku tunjuk perasaan.